Online session on basic electronics. In today's session, we'll be learning about oscillators. Okay, so an oscillator is a circuit which produces a continuous repeated alternating waveform without any input. Okay, so we can say that basically oscillators, it converts unidirectional current flow from a DC source into an alternating waveform which is of the desired frequency as decided by its circuit components. Oh, okay, so it is an electronic circuit which uses positive feedback and generates the output which oscillates with constant frequency and amplitude. Oscillators are an important class of every electronic circuit and are used in almost every electronic systems. For example, oscillators are employed to produce sinusoidal signals that are used as carrier in radio and television broadcasts. Oscillators are also used to produce the square wave used as clock in computers and other synchronous digital systems. Okay, so it is a circuit which provides provides oscillations without any input. So this input, how we get is we are giving a positive feedback. Okay, so that because of using this positive feedback, it generates the output which oscillates or it is repeated with constant frequency and amplitude. So we can say that oscillators convert direct current, okay, that is DC, from a power supply to an alternating current, that is AC signal. Okay, because of this, they are used widely in electronic devices ranging from simplest clock generators to digital instruments. Okay, there are different types of oscillators. Okay, based on the what kind of circuit we are using, we have different types of oscillators. Okay, the main principle in case of oscillator is that there is a the output is fed back to the input in phase. This is the main principle. Okay, so an oscillator always employs a sensitive amplifier whose output is fed back to the input in phase. Okay, thus the signal regenerates and sustains itself. Okay, so application of oscillators, you can see in quartz watches, that is, it uses a crystal oscillator. It is also used in various audio systems and video systems. Okay, it is used in computers, metal detectors, inverters, ultrasonic and radio frequency application, etc. Okay, mainly oscillators are divided into two types, that is, linear and non-linear oscillator. Linear oscillators will give you sinusoidal output, whereas non-linear oscillator will give you non-sinusoidal or complex waveforms like square, sawtooth, okay, rectangular, like this waveforms. So mainly classified into two types, linear oscillator and non-linear oscillator. Okay, now this is a general block diagram of an oscillator. You can see here in the block there is an amplifier, right? Then there is a feedback network. So we have already studied about feedback amplifiers. Okay, so how feedback is given, which is if it is given to the positive, then it is positive feedback amplifier or in phase, and if it is out phase, it is a negative feedback amplifier. So here in case of oscillator, we are taking a positive feedback amplifier. Why we are using positive feedback? Because positive feedback is used to have more gain. Okay, so the oscillator, the gain for oscillator, the gain should be at maximum to have sustained oscillations. Okay, on the other hand, negative feedback, it will decrease the gain. But we can see that in negative feedback, it makes the system stable. So that is why it is used in amplifiers. Okay, but in case of oscillator, we are using positive feedback. Okay, so here input signal is given, that is Vs, that is the input signal, and then the VF is the feedback signal, okay, and it is a positive feedback signal that is given, and the input to the amplifier VI, after taking the portion of output, then we get VI, then it is given to the amplifier and we get the output. And since the feedback is given is in phase, input signal and output signal also will be in phase. Okay, so this is mainly the block diagram of an oscillator. So we have an amplifier, then the oscillator circuit, then the positive feedback network. Okay, so we can say that actually it is a conversion of DC into AC using a power supply. Okay, so an oscillator is a circuit that produces a periodic waveform on its output with only the DC supply voltage as an input. The output voltage can be either sinusoidal or non-sinusoidal depending on the type of oscillator. Since here we are considering a positive feedback. Okay, let us take the derivation. We have already solved this derivation in the previous session of feedback amplifier. You can check that. Okay, so consider a non-inverting amplifier with a voltage gain and positive feedback network with feedback gain of beta as shown in the figure. So this is a figure. So here let us consider a circuit where we have amplifier, then the feedback which has a gain beta. Okay, and amplifier gain is A. Okay, that is what we are considering. A sinusoidal input signal Vs is applied as an input to the non-inverting amplifier. Therefore, output signal V0 is in phase with the Vs. A feedback network feeds the part of V0 to the input and the amount V0 feedback depends on the feedback network gain beta. Okay, already we have done the derivation for V0, that is the gain. Okay, so after we solve the derivation, we get AF. AF as A divided by 1 minus A beta. So if you want to get understand how we got AF is equal to 1 minus A beta, look back to the section of feedback amplifier for positive feedback. Then we have got the derivation and we will get AF is equal to A divided by 1 minus beta for where beta is the feedback factor. Okay, for constant A, that is amplifier gain A, for various value of beta, the gain increases. Now, if you say that at beta is equal to 1 by A, okay, when beta is equal to 1 by A, if you substitute here beta is equal to 1 by A, then 1 minus A beta is 0, or A divided by 0 is, we get AF is infinite. So this indicates that produces the circuit produces output without input, that is Vs is equal to 0. So gain is infinite. The circuit gets driven by the feedback signal and produces the oscillation. The positive feedback increases the closed loop gain at beta is equal to 1 by A. That is how the circuit works and as an oscillator. Okay, so here very important criteria we have to study for, you know, maintaining an oscillation. First one is that the loop gain must be unity or it should be greater. That means the loop gain is nothing but the gain of the amplifier and the gain of the feedback. So that is A into beta. It should be greater than 1 or it should be equal to 1. Okay, the second main criteria, that is the second criteria of Barkhausen, is that the phase shift around the loop is 0 or an integer multiple of 2 pi. Okay, that is the phase shift of the entire network around this complete loop, including the feedback. The phase shift, whatever we get, should be 0 degree or multiple of 2 pi. Okay, so it should be the 0 degree or 360 degree, like that. Okay, so this is the main two conditions which are required for getting a sustained oscillation. What is the first criteria? First criteria says that the loop gain must be unity or greater than 1. The second criteria says that the phase shift around the loop is 0 or an integer multiple of 2 pi. Okay, so there are three diagrams in front of you. The first diagram is showing when A beta is greater than 1. So it will increase the oscillations. Okay, so keeping the amplitude goes on increasing. In figure B, it is A beta less than 1. So it is the oscillations are getting, you know, destroyed. Okay, that is the second figure. Third figure is when A beta is equal to 1. Okay, there we will get sustained oscillation. Okay, same amplitude will be sustained throughout. Okay, that is a repeated waveform produced. So we have to get the C for getting a sustained oscillation. Okay. So let us see different type of circuit. So in different type of circuit, you will be studying about RC phase shift oscillator and Wien bridge oscillator. So RC phase shift oscillator, as the name indicates, RC. That means it's a circuit provided by, you know, having a network of resistors and capacitor. Okay, and that oscillator circuit will provide oscillations. Okay, so it consists of an inverting amplifier followed by a feedback network with phase shift of 180 degree. So we know that inverting amplifier means it will produce a phase shift of 180 degree. That means a feedback network should have a phase shift of 180 degree to sustain the Barkhausen criterion. Okay. So in case of Barkhausen criterion, we also see that the phase shift should be either 0 degree or 360 degree. So in this case, inverting amplifier we are using, that's why already there will be a 180 degree phase shift. Then the feedback network will provide another 180 degree of phase shift. The 180 degree phase shift at the feedback can be obtained by the combination of resistors and capacitor. This network is called as RC phase shift oscillator circuit. So here the transistor amplifier itself produces a phase shift of 180 degree. So the RC phase shift oscillator produces a sine wave output signal using regenerative feedback from RC combination. This regenerative feedback from RC network is due to the ability of the capacitor to store an electric charge. So see the circuit diagram here. So we are using a feedback circuit like this, which is having three capacitor and three resistors, okay, and this is the normal, you know, BJT which we are using. It is an NPN transistor, okay. So here if you see, this is the network. There is a phase shift of 180 degree that will be produced by this kind of network, okay. So this is a circuit diagram you need to draw for RC phase shift oscillator, okay. So, in case of RC phase shift oscillator, the network analysis, when do we do the network analysis, then that is to produce a phase shift of 180 degree, this network attenuates the output voltage by a factor of 1/29. So, using network analysis, we find that beta is equal to 1/29. This means that the amplifier must have a voltage gain of 29 or more, because we know that A into beta is equal to 1. So, beta, if it is 1/29, then A should be 29 to meet the condition of Barkhausen. Okay, so when the amplifier voltage gain is 29, feedback factor of RC network beta is equal to 1/29, then the loop gain is beta is equal to 1. So the amplifier phase shift minus 180 degree with the network phase shift of plus 180 degree gives a loop phase shift of 0. So both of these conditions are necessary to satisfy the Barkhausen criteria. If the amplifier gain is greater than 29, the oscillator output waveform is likely to be distorted. When the gain is slightly greater than 29, the output is usually a reasonable pure sinusoidal waveform. Okay, so the R and C of the phase shift network must be selected so as to produce a phase shift of 180 degree. The generalized equation of frequency of oscillation by RC phase shift of oscillator is given by F is equal to 1/2 pi RC into root of 2n, where F is the output frequency in hertz, R is the resistance in ohms, C is the capacitance in farad, and N is the number of RC stages. And in case of this kind of circuit, it is N is equal to 3. Okay, so next let us see about Wien bridge oscillator. So, Wien bridge oscillator also produces a sine wave. It is a RC network. Okay, it produces a sine wave which uses RC network as a frequency determining the portion of the circuit. Okay, so the Wien bridge oscillator is so called because the circuit is based on a frequency selective form of a Wheatstone bridge circuit. The Wien bridge oscillator is a two-stage RC coupled amplifier circuit that has good stability at its resonant frequency, low distortion, and is very easy to tune, making it a popular circuit as an audio frequency oscillator. But the phase shift of the output signal is considerably different from previous RC oscillator which we studied. The Wien bridge oscillator uses a feedback circuit consisting of series RC circuit with connected with a parallel RC of the same component values, producing a phase delay or phase advance circuit depending upon the frequency. At the resonant frequency FR, the phase shift is 0 degree. Okay, so let us see this circuit. If you see this, the main difference between the general oscillator and Wien bridge oscillator is that the amplifier stages introduce 180 degree phase shift, and additional 180 degree phase shift is introduced by the feedback network so as to obtain 360 degree or zero phase shift around the loop to satisfy Barkhausen criteria. That is what we see in RC phase shift. But in case of Wien bridge oscillator, a non-inverting amplifier is used. Okay, so that means there is no phase shift. That is, the stage does not introduce any phase shift. Hence, there is no need of phase shift through the feedback network. So, this is because of this, the feedback network will produce a phase shift of 0 degree, because already we are using a non-inverting amplifier. Okay. So, if you see the circuit diagram, the Wien bridge network comprises of four arms connected in a bridge fashion. Here, two arms are purely resistive, while the other two arms are combination of resistor and capacitor. In one arm, it has a resistor and capacitor connected in series, while in the other, resistor and capacitor is connected in parallel. That is, R2 and C2 are in parallel, and R1 and C1 is in series. The operation amplifier is used in a non-inverting configuration and feedback from a voltage divider network. The resistance R1 and R3 forms a part of the feedback path which determines or facilitates to adjust the amplifier gain. The output of op-amp is connected as input to the bridge at node 1 and 3, right? While the output of the bridge at node 2 and 4 are connected as the input to the op-amp. A portion of the amplifier output is fed back through the voltage divider network, that is a series combination of resistor and capacitor, to the positive or non-inverting terminal of the amplifier. Also, the second portion of amplifier is fed back to the inverting or negative terminal of the amplifier through the impedance of magnitude 2R. If the feedback network elements are chosen properly, the phase shift of the signal input to the amplifier is zero at certain frequency. Since the amplifier is non-inverting, which introduces zero phase shift plus the feedback network zero phase shift, the total phase shift becomes zero around the loop, hence required condition of oscillation. Okay, so as I told you, it consists of four arms and two arms are purely resistor and other two arms are combination of resistor and capacitor. Since the amplifier is non-inverting, which introduces zero phase shift plus the feedback network introduces zero phase shift, the total phase shift becomes zero around the loop, hence it's required for oscillation. Okay, so the Wien bridge oscillator, after the derivation, we get that the resonant frequency FR is equal to 1 by 2 pi RC. FR is the output frequency in hertz and R is the resistance in ohm and C is the capacitance in farads. At resonant frequency, the feedback fraction is equal to 1 divided by 3. It means that in bridge oscillator, there is both positive and negative feedback. If resistors R1 equal to R2 and C1 equal to C2 in the circuit, then the resonant frequency F is equal to 1 by 2 pi RC. And to achieve a gain of 3, R4 by R3 should be equal to 2. Okay, so that is how we will find the gain, because it is a non-inverting amplifier, and the gain of non-inverting amplifier we already know. Okay, substituting that, we will get in the resonant frequency beta should be equal to 1 by 3. Okay, so that is about Wien bridge oscillator and RC phase shift oscillator. So here in this, you can expect questions on just drawing the circuit diagram, writing the equation and writing the working. Okay, so these two questions are important, RC phase shift oscillator and Wien bridge oscillator. I hope this session is clear for you. Thank you.